second, it's Graham lifting, toe fading. Gonzalez in second, and Graham closing on the record. And he's done it.
When fast becomes too fast, disaster can strike. Too fast is when you speed past your personal limit and burst through the envelope out of control. Too fast can also be caused by the machine, by a 10-cent part, or a million-dollar engine, or by a piece of debris on the track, or by the wind. Too fast is terror. That terror happens in an instant in sports like drag racing. Don Prudhomme thought his opponent had been killed in this accident. It tore him apart. He wanted to quit.
I think I'm going to quit. I seen that car go by. I couldn't believe it. There was no back section on it or nothing.
Driver Jim Nichols was okay, and Don Prudhomme did not quit the sport. When a woman then known as Chacho Muldowney, although she hated the name, qualified for the national final, Big Daddy Don Garlitz could hardly believe it.
Got him, but she blew. We got a long wait. We got plenty of time. He's in the final.
The lady dragster driver is in the final.
That's right.
What do you think about going against the gal?
Well, I owe her one from Columbus.
Well, Big Daddy successfully defended his male domain that day, but Shirley Muldowney, who would become the only woman to beat males in a national sport, won his respect forevermore.
She's got further in drag racing right now than any woman ever has. I mean, you know, runner up. You got to understand that that's a fantastic thing. This is the U.S. National.
We all have had that dangerous dream of driving faster and faster on the open road. We know it's wrong, so most of us don't do it. Instead, we play make-believe by watching the stock car drivers of the NASCAR circuit. But even they can lose it, like Cale Yarborough at Darlington.
Look, he's getting far enough up, and those boys are in trouble. Oh! Oh, Yarborough right out of the racetrack.
How far did the car go, Cale?
Oh, I don't know. Must have went 200 yards.
And did you have any injuries at all?
No, none whatsoever. I was lucky.
Did they get the breath knocked out of you?
No. I was real lucky.
The race driver depends not only on himself and his car, but on the other guy in his car. A.J. Foyt was cruising to victory on the final lap at Indianapolis in 1967 when a race driver's nightmare happened in the final turn.
In an incredible, thrilling finish.
Recently, AJ said he couldn't see, but drove through the crash as fast as he could, so that if he hit someone, he would drag him across the finish line and still win. Racing luck is needed. This was the greatest of stock car drivers, Richard Petty, at Darlington in 1970. Luck was with him. He wasn't hurt. But his greatest triumph came at the famous Daytona International Speedway. In all, Petty has won Daytona 7 times. They don't call him King Richard for nothing. His daddy drove at Daytona before him, and now his son Kyle races on the Grand National Circuit. In 1984, he was trying for a historic 200th win in the Firecracker 400 at Daytona. It was a day for ceremony. To give the traditional call to the driver, a high-flying president took to the airwaves.
Right. Gentlemen, start your engines.
Petty scored his 200th that day. As he won, the experts intoned their belief that no one would approach his record, but Richard knows that all records are made to be broken. Mario Andretti drove his first race car at age 12 in Italy. His family moved to America, and he became a young star at Indy, later an international celebrity. He won the Indianapolis 500 in 1969, but has been dogged by bad luck there ever since. Still, he remains the only Indy winner to be kissed not by the beauty queen, but by the car owner. Inside, his Italian boyhood dream still burned. To win the world championship on the Grand Prix circuit, only one American, Phil Hill, had ever achieved that goal. In his native land in 1978, only he and teammate Ronnie Peterson had a chance to win the title. Which would it be? In 1961, it had been the same situation on the same track with Bill Hill and his teammate Count Von Trips. Trips was killed in the race, and Hill won a sad victory. Now it was deja vu in a terrible way. On the start, a crash. Peterson was in it and would die overnight. Andretti went on to win the title, but the champagne was bitter, and the word victory had a hollow sound. So speed raises questions. How fast is fast, and how fast is too fast? And is fast worth the danger? Is fast really important after all? Some call the love of speed a death wish, but others say no, it's a wish to beat death. The drag racer, Don Garlitz, told us 11 years ago that he might have had enough.
I'm 43, I've been in racing 25 years. I've made a lot of money, I've had a lot of friends, I've had a lot of good times. My family is pressuring me, you know. They say, you know, you've been doing it a long time and the chances are getting greater and greater that maybe you'll have a severe accident. I tell you, I'm going to give it some serious thought, because like I say, I'm 43 years old, I'll be 44 before the next season starts, and I'm really going to think about it this winter.
Well, Don has been thinking about it so seriously and so long that Don Garlitz is still at it. This was done last month in Gainesville, Florida, 272.56 miles per hour, a new world record. Not bad for old Big Daddy. With us now is Big Daddy Don Garlitz. Don, good to see you.